What's going on, guys? Welcome to week number 3 of the 2017 NFL season. And here we are with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers taking on the Seattle Seahawks at home. And one team here is going to lose their first game of the season. Both teams 2-0 starting out. And looking at the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, number 4 in NFL standing. 64 points for and 44 against the Seattle Seahawks, two spots behind us at number 6. And they have 61 points for and 44 against. Both of these teams very evenly matched. But you see here, the quarterback position is going to be the huge thing here. Can Mike Glennon outplay Russell Wilson, who has a 96 overall and is very keen at both, you know, staying in the pocket and also running? Marshawn Lynch, beast mode. We have to worry about him. He's backed up by Kyrie Robinson and Darnard Robinson. And then at receiver, Percy Harvin, Tavon Austin, Kenny Stills, Ted Ginn, and Ace Sanders. A receiving core that really isn't that tall. I mean, their tallest guy is Kenny Stills at 6 foot even. But what these guys lack in height, they make up for in speed. We cannot play man coverage against them if they decide to go spread. And a lot of people looking to me to repeat my performance from last week as I was named NFC Defensive Player of the Week in my second game as a rookie. Can I get another interception here against Russell Wilson and this very efficient Seahawks offense? Better question, can our offense play good against the Legion of Boom? Let's find out. Week 2 is underway. And welcome back to Raymond James Stadium for week 3 of this NFL season, Monday Night Football, as the Seattle Seahawks are in town to take on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Most NFL analysts have picked the Seattle Seahawks to win this week's matchup, but this Tampa Bay defense is fired up. We're looking to put a stop to Marshawn Lynch and his running, and Lovie Smith is looking to get a win against Rex Ryan, as Rex Ryan is looking to stay perfect in his second season as the head coach of the Seattle Seahawks. So we get things started with a field goal. Seattle to the field here, first and 10 at the 20. And Wilson in the shotgun as he'll drop back, throw short for Ace Sanders. Sanders with the catch. And he's not going anywhere. That's a first down, but he has stopped very quickly after a gain of about 10. Seattle comes out in the eye here, first down at 10. Ball to 30 is Marshawn Lynch. Nowhere to go. And he's brought down by Kyler Woodyard, who has done a great job of stopping the run this season. Second down to 9 as Seattle comes out here, single back formation, tight end in motion to the backfield. And it'll be a counter to Marshawn Lynch, and he's got nowhere to go. Another 1 yard carry for Lynch as Gooden gets there, and that'll bring up 3rd and 7. And we'll see our first 5-wide formation of the game as we'll bring pressure with the safety. And Russell Wilson throwing this one to Ted Ginn, and Ginn down the sideline as he's got a first down and more. And that'll get them past the 50 down to the 36 yard line. And that was just bad coverage downfield. We got to play better than that. We'll come out here first down and 10, man coverage. And this will be Russell Wilson getting away from one, but not away from Gerald McCoy, as I believe the first guy there was Kyler Woodyard coming off the blitz. I could be wrong. And we'll take one more look at this. Actually, that was Armand Gleers coming on the blitz from the corner position. Brought a nickel corner on the blitz, and that slowed down Russell Wilson just enough for Gerald McCoy to get there. Seattle in the shotgun on 2nd and 16. Handoff for Marshawn Lynch up the middle, and Lynch picking up about 7 yards. And that'll make it a 3rd and 9 from about the 35-yard line as we're inside of 5 minutes here in the first quarter. Russell Wilson, dual running backs in the backfield. And this one will be a pass as Wilson's going to stay in the pocket, throwing this one towards the sideline. And that one is caught out of bounds. That was the fullback Harris for Seattle with the near catch, and that'll bring up 4th and 9. And they'll send Mike Nugent on the field for a 52-yard field goal attempt. This ball just to the left of the right hash mark, and this one will be a good hold as Mike Nugent kicking this one downfield, and he did not get it to the left. That one went straight forward, and that's a missed field goal. Seattle with no points here on their first possession of the game. Our offense cannot increase the lead. Still a 3-0 game here with 2 minutes left in the first quarter as I nearly got to Lynch, and Lynch down the sideline, breaking 2 tackles, and he is shoved out of bounds at the 38. We had Lynch, and then we lost him. I didn't even touch Lynch. I actually went ahead and I tackled Russell Wilson, which I definitely wasn't trying to do. Here goes another carry for Lynch here on 2nd down and 11. That one good for about 8 yards. That'll make it a 3rd and 3. And we're expecting a run here from the Seattle Seahawks, but it's going to be a pass as Russell Wilson trying to take off the run here, and he's not going to get the first down. Stop just short. That'll bring up 4th and inches, and we'll see a punt here from Seattle as Russell Wilson nearly got the first down. This is something we have to be aware of at all time, Russell Wilson's running ability. And I got there just in time to force the punt, but Seattle with the ball here at the 10-yard line after a turnover. And it'll be first down and 10 from the 10-yard line. Marshawn Lynch carrying off tackle, this one going nowhere, and he's kept to a gain of 1. Rex Ryan and the Seahawks have been kept scoreless here in this first quarter. But we expect things to change here in the second as they get things started from the 9-yard line. And Marshawn Lynch with a carry up the middle. And he stood up at the 6-yard line. That's my second tackle of the game. And that one was pretty impressive. No beast mode on me. Marshawn Lynch taking on pretty solidly. Now we have a 3rd and 6. No running backs in the backfield. Russell Wilson 5 wide. And he's standing in the pocket. He'll get taken down by Sendarek Marks. And the fumble is forced, but we can't recover. As Sendarek Marks beats the double team and gets to Wilson. And we just could not fall on the football. That would have been a great turnover here in the red zone. And we could have kept them from getting any points. But nice awareness by their offensive lineman diving on the football. And they'll send Mike Nugent on the field for a 29-yard attempt. This one up and that one right down the middle. As Seattle ties this ball game up here in the second quarter. Our offense failing the score once again. Harris in motion. Hand off to Marshawn Lynch to the outside. I can't get away from Harris. And Marshawn Lynch with a near first down. That one good for about 8 or 9 yards as Marshawn Lynch having a pretty solid game. But those numbers are slightly inflated because of the missed tackle that we had in the previous possession. Would have stopped him in the backfield. And on 2nd and 2, Russell Wilson 5 wide in the shotgun. And we'll bring 4 as Russell Wilson throwing this one deep down the middle. That was my zone and I was totally not paying attention. I was looking for the short pass to the tight end and he went down the middle for Ace Sanders. So now to be a 1st down and 10. Another carry here for Marshawn Lynch on 1st down and 10 as he's got maybe 4 yards on that one. And it'll be a 2nd and 6 from the 25. 3rd and 2 from the 21. And we're definitely expecting run here for Marshawn Lynch. It's, he's got the carry and he's hit short, but he manages to fall forward. And that'll be a 1st down for Seattle. The Seahawks are marching down the field here just outside of 5 minutes. Ball at the 18-yard line. And Russell Wilson spinning, taken down by Kyler Woodyard. As he got afraid that Sendarek Marks was going to get to him once again. And that is Kyler Woodyard coming up with the sack. That's only a loss of about 1 or 2, but the sack counts. Actually, they lost no yards on the sack. 2nd and 10, ball at the 18 once again. Another carry for Lynch, and he's going to stumble forward for about 5 yards, bringing up 3rd down and 5. Can we keep Seattle to a field goal once again? It's going to be Lynch in the backfield. Russell Wilson dropping back the pass as he's going to try to take off the run, and he's taken down again. Sendarek Marks with his 2nd sack of the game. That brings up 4th and 11. And this defensive line just cannot be stopped. Sendarek Marks beating another double team. And that'll bring up a 4th and 11 as Mike Nugent here to kick a 36-yard field goal. Kicks up. Kick is good. And Seattle will take a 6-3 lead here with a little bit of time left in the second quarter. And our offense turning the ball over again. Are you kidding me? Ball at the 10-yard line once again for Seattle as they'll come out here and they'll try to run the ball with Lynch to the outside. And Kyler Woodyard says no way Jose. Loss of 2, 2nd and 12 upcoming. Our offense is really killing us right now. They can't move the ball down the field and they're giving Seattle short fields to work with as Marshawn Lynch another carry here and he's brought down by Michael Johnson and that'll bring up 3rd and 7. Best case scenario, we'll keep them to another field goal. Worst case scenario, they go up by a touchdown and then we go into the half down by 2 scores. 3rd down and 7. Russell Wilson throwing to the flat for Denard Robinson, and that one will not get them into the end zone. That'll bring up a 4th and 4, and I'm not entirely sure where Wilson was going with that pass. That's the 2nd time he's done that. And Mike Nugent for the 4th field goal of the game. This one from 21 yards out, and this one is right down the middle, just a little more than the extra point. And Seattle with a 9-3 lead. And our offense cannot do anything once again. 9-3 lead still in the second quarter. At least get to halftime. As that one will be completed to the tight end, and that one going nowhere. That's going to be a no gain for Seattle. That'll bring up 2nd down and 10. Seattle has the ball at the 38. We have to keep them out of field goal range. So we're bringing a blitz here. 2nd down and 10. Russell Wilson dropping back. Throwing this one over the middle. That one caught, but not really going anywhere. Is that one good for about 3 yards? And Seattle calling their 2nd time out of the first half with a minute left. Trying to see what they can do here to get this ball past the 1st down mark. And 3rd down and 7. We'll bring pressure. We don't want to let Russell Wilson drop back and pass his ball as they don't even block me. I come in and down goes Russell Wilson. That'll take him out of field goal range for sure. That'll bring a 4th and 12 from the 40. And Mike Nugent missing from 52 yards earlier. That'll be a 57-yard attempt that he is definitely not going to make. So that'll end the first half. 1st down and 10 for Seattle from the 20 to start the second. As it'll be a handoff to Marshawn Lynch and I take out his legs from under him. And that's good for about 4 yards as Russell Wilson will take a look at some of the plays here by the defense. Russell Wilson been under a lot of pressure this entire game. Sendarek Marks with 2, Kyler Woodyard with 1, I come in and get one at the end of the first half. I mean, our defense is just bringing all types of pressure, and our offense just can't seem to find a way into the end zone, or at least down the field for a field goal, as Russell Wilson taking off the run here once again, and I can't get to him as Russell Wilson scrambling, picks up a good carry, and that'll get them down to the 35. I took a pretty terrible angle trying to get to Wilson on that play. It'll be a handoff for Lynch here on first down and 10. And he gets away from Princeton Mukamara, but Fitzgerald there for the cleanup tackle. Second down and 8 after the gain of 2. And Russell Wilson will hand off to Marshawn Lynch on the draw. And that one going nowhere as Marshawn Lynch taken down in the backfield. Loss of 3. And actually get credit for that tackle. He ran right into my pile, and for some reason I get credit for the tackle there. I'm not entirely sure why, but I'm not going to complain about it. That'll bring up 3rd and 11. We have to get the stop here. 3rd and 11. No first downs for Seattle. Get the ball back to our offense. As Cedric Marks nearly got to Wilson again, and I'm there for the cleanup tackle, and that will end up being a sack. 4th down and 14. Loss of 3. And Russell Wilson looked like he was about to take off the run again, as Cedric Marks nearly got to Russell Wilson for the 3rd sack of the game. And I got there just before Gerald McCoy got there. And now to get the ball back to our offense, and hopefully these guys can put some points on the board. But once again, no response from our offense. Our defense keeping Seattle to 9 points here throughout pretty much 2.5 quarters. And here goes Russell Wilson dropping back the pass. He's going to throw this one towards the flat for the fullback. Actually, that's the tight end. And that one good for only about 3 yards. This defense is playing tough, but our offense is really killing us right now with these lack of points here in this game. I know it's Seattle, but we got to play better against that defense as Russell Wilson throwing for Ace Sanders here over the middle. That one caught, but Ace Sanders gets popped. And Ace Sanders looks to be injured, and he does not look to be getting up. That looks like some type of upper body injury as he got laid out in the hit. And we'll take a look at this one more time via instant replay as we brought a blitz from the corner. And Woodard and Fitzgerald just let Ace Sanders have the inside. And I have to come over in the middle and lay a hit. That shouldn't have happened. Woodard should have been there, but not going to complain. I put another player out here in week number 3. Aaron Rodgers was the victim last week. Here we go. 3rd down and inches. Hand off to Lynch. We knew it was going to be a run. And Lynch picks up about 4 yards on that one, making it 1st down at 28. We had a chance to get a stop. Couldn't get it. Marshawn Lynch again. Hand off up the field. He's got a good carry for a 1st down, and that'll be a 1st down for Seattle at the 38-yard line as he picks up 10. That's my 9th tackle of the game. Another carry here for Lynch as he gets a misdirection carry. Good carry up the middle for about 4. Seattle is really trying to go to work with the run game here in this possession, and we need to find a way to counter that as we'll bring a blitz here, and I actually end up jumping off sides just accidentally, and I get Marshawn Lynch in the backfield, but it doesn't matter as that'll be a offsides call, and that'll give Seattle a free 5 yards. 2nd down and 2. And this one, hand off to the outside. Kyrie Robinson not getting the 1st down as I get away from the receiver. And that was a pretty solid tackle there. As you look at our time of possession, they're only 7 minutes with the ball. That is not good at all. 3rd down and 1. We expect run for Marshawn Lynch. It is a run, and actually that's Kyrie Robinson to the outside. He gets the 1st down as we did not contain the edge. That was probably my fault. 1st down and 10. Russell Wilson dropping back the pass, looking for someone to get the ball to. Throwing downfield, Denard Robinson with the catch, getting away from Fitzgerald. And he's brought down by Amukamara inside the 5-yard line, actually at the 5-yard line. As Russell Wilson having a pretty solid game, 10 for 11, 127 yards. Denard Robinson, 2nd catch of the game for 42. Hand off to the outside for Lynch. Nowhere to go on that one. As Kyler Woodard again, shutting down the outside carries. No stretch runs on this defense. 2nd down and goal from the 7. 3rd quarter's almost over. This one will be a carry to the outside for Kyrie Robinson. He's taken down the backfield. Nowhere to go on that one. 3rd down and goal. We need a stop, and that's my 11th tackle of the game. Rex Ryan does not look happy. And here we go. 4th quarter just getting started. 3rd down and goal from the 7. Wilson in the shotgun. Going to take off the run to the left. And no. Oh, my goodness. Russell Wilson scores a touchdown because these controls, they wouldn't let me turn quick enough to get Russell Wilson to keep him picking up the 1st down and eventually a touchdown. And our offense finally scores, down by 7. 17-10 is Marshawn Lynch getting a carry here to the outside, and he'll get away from 1, and he won't get away from 2 as he's brought down after a gain of about 2 yards. Next week we have a bye week followed by the Jets, Eagles, and Panthers. Seattle comes to the field here, three wide, Lynch in the backfield, offset as Wilson will hand off to Lynch up the middle, and Marshawn Lynch first down carry as he officially crosses 100 yards in the game. This will be another carry here for Lynch, it looks like, as he'll get the carry. That's actually Kyrie Robinson, and we've been able to contain him this game, but Marshawn Lynch has really been the problem. 7 minutes left here in the game, second and 12 as Russell Wilson drops back the pass, throwing for the tight end. Sure, he has the catch, but I knock it loose. This ball picked up by Alteron Werner, and that's going to be a turnover. Finally, we get the stop and the turnover we need, and our offense is going to get started at the 40-yard line. What a time for a fumble, as that was just a huge hit to knock the ball loose. And boy, oh boy, if we could have run that one back for a touchdown. But it's all good. We got the stop. Hopefully, our offense can get the touchdown and tie this game up. As you're going to see here, Russell Wilson had the pass he wanted. And Haley just got popped. You can't do anything about it. That looks just like the play I had against Miami in my senior year. And we actually ended up losing that game, so it's probably not a good comparison to make. It was a very similar route as I was playing outside. Came back inside to make the hit on the tight end who had made kind of an angle route. And just very, very similar fumble. Similar situation. Hopefully the outcome of the game is different. And this ball game is officially tied up. The comeback is real. As Russell Wilson working from under center here. First down to 10. Hand off to Lynch. It's Gerald McCoy. Not giving up too much room. Only gained a 2 there for Lynch. As he's still over 100 yards. And he's kind of been going back and forth. Gerald McCoy only 3 tackles in the game so far. Second down and 8. Bringing both safeties on the blitz. As Russell Wilson standing strong in the pocket. Throwing for Denard Robinson. And no! Denard Robinson gets free, and he's going to score a touchdown, and we just give up the lead just like that. Robinson is just too fast to play in man-to-man coverage with a linebacker, despite how good Kyler Woodyer it is. That was just not a fair matchup. We had no safety help over the top, and Denard Robinson going downfield and scoring a touchdown. But our offense all of a sudden is back in this football game, 24-24 ball game. We just need one stop. No more blitzes from the safeties. We're playing this game safe as Marshawn Lynch nowhere to go. Xavier Gooden with the tackle in the backfield. Beautiful stop there as that'll keep Marshawn Lynch to about 1 or 2 yards. Maybe not any at all. Actually, he loses 2 yards in that play. Second down and 12, ball at the 18-yard line. And they'll send a tight end in motion. We'll bring pressure here with the linebackers as Russell Wilson dropping back. And he has no time to get rid of it as that one is incomplete. Third down and 12. The pressure is all on the defense. Can we get a stop here? Third down and 12. Russell Wilson in the shotgun, bunched to the right side of the field. And Wilson will drop back the pass, getting pressure, thrown off balance for Denard Robinson. And Denard Robinson dropped it. I don't know how Russell Wilson got rid of that pass like that, but we got so lucky on this play. What a blatant drop by Denard Robinson. This is why you don't play receiver. This is why you're a running back. In the NFL, Ted Ginn is upset. And Seattle punting from inside their own 5-yard line. I need to set my team up with solid field position on this punt return. And this one will be fielded from about the 20. And I'll bring this one up and make a move back to the inside. And that will be good for about 14 yards. Buccaneers offense will get started from the 32-yard line. So not a bad return, but we can't do anything with it. And it comes down to the defense once again. Can we get a stop? No blitzes from the safeties throughout the entire rest of this game as Russell Wilson trying to run, and he's taken down by Quentin Hobbs. Sendarek Marks is getting to Russell Wilson quite easily, but he can't seem to bring him down after the first 2 sacks. I mean, take a look at this one more time. Sendarek Marks got there, got broken off, and Quentin Hobbs with the cleanup sack. But that is a beautiful job by Quentin Hobbs finding Russell Wilson after you turn around. And that'll bring up second down and 13. 2-minute warning approaching. And Harris in motion. Hand off to Marshawn Lynch to the outside, and he's not going anywhere. Gooden with the tackle, and that'll take us to the 2-minute warning as we have a third down and 14 for Seattle upcoming. All we need to do here is get a stop, and this game is back under Tampa Bay control. We need a field goal, and this game is pretty much done. Checking out the scoring summary here. What a fourth quarter by our offense. Put up 21 points, and that has us back in this game. Third down and 14, 2 minutes, and it's going to be a handoff to the outside for Lynch, and Amukamara blowing that play up in the backfield as they'll lose 2. And I don't know what Seattle's doing here. We have plenty of time to get our offense in good position, and for some reason I didn't call a timeout. I'm looking at this now. I'm like, why didn't I call a timeout? We have 3 left, but we might as well just save it all for the offense as they're going to try to get this ball down the field, and I'll return this one and try to get to the outside, and that one not really going anywhere. as they'll have to get started from the 22-yard line. That was a bad return. That was my fault. But here we go, looking at what our offense is going to do. Next play, incomplete pass. 12-yard play to Gresham. Mike Evans downfield, 21 yards and 34 yards. And it's going to be a first down at the 11-yard line. And what just happened? We're going to overtime. What in the world just happened? There's no... We have two timeouts. Why didn't they use a timeout and kick the field goal? But now we're in overtime. This is ridiculous. Madden just screwed us. And now the Seahawks have the ball to start overtime. And here goes Marshawn Lynch. Up the middle. And that'll be good for a gain of about 7 yards. We have to get a stop here. We can't be angry that our offense just screwed us over. We've been playing good this entire game, and we have to find a way to stop Seattle as they'll hand off to Marshawn Lynch again to the outside. That's actually Kyrie Robinson. He's brought down. Nowhere to go. He's brought down the backfield. That's going to bring up 3rd and 4. And the outcome of this game could come down to this next play. Can we stop Seattle on 3rd and 4, or will we give up the first down? This defense has been playing solid really this entire game with the exception of a couple of plays. And now we have a 3rd and 4. Russell Wilson, 2 running backs in the backfield. He'll be in the shotgun. And they'll drop back the pass as Russell Wilson throwing to the left side of the field for the fullback. That went complete. And that'll be a first down for Seattle as they got the ball at the 33-yard line. I thought we were playing cover 3. Someone should have been there protecting the flats. 1st and 10. It's going to be another carry up the middle for Robinson as Woodyard misses on the tackle. And that'll be a first down or a near first down for Seattle, bringing up 2nd and 1. A false start will back the Seahawks up 5 yards, making it 2nd and 6 from the 37-yard line. And Wilson will drop back the pass here, and he'll throw the comeback route to Kenny Stills. And we were not looking for the comeback route. I was coming back up the field to protect the receiver running across the middle on the drag route. But now to be a 1st and 10 as Marshawn Lynch returns to the field. He'll get a carry here up the middle, but nowhere to really go as Gooden has been in his face this entire game. And that went only good for about 3 yards. 2nd down and 7, ball at the 49-yard line. We have to get a stop here, or at least keep these guys to a field goal. As Russell Wilson will take off the run downfield, and I can't get the tackle as I just completely missed. Russell Wilson gets down to the 15, and things are not looking good. We've kept them to 3 field goals in the red zone, but this offense is looking to score. 1st and 10 from the 15. Seattle in the I formation as they'll pass this one to the tight end, and I really wish I had forced a fumble on that play. We could have used a turnover right there, but that one will be good for about 5 yards. And it'll be a 2nd and 5 here for Seattle. Marshawn Lynch, single back in the backfield. They'll come out here with 2 tight ends. And they'll send a tight end in motion to the right side of the field. Hand off for Lynch. And Marshawn Lynch will score. And this game is over. Marshawn Lynch with the overtime ending touchdown. And that is definitely not how we want to end this game. Marshawn Lynch going untouched into the end zone. And that'll do it here for week 3 as we are officially 2-1 on the season with our first loss, even though we were robbed. The Madden simulation messed us up, but a loss is a loss. We can't do anything about it. Rex Ryan still perfect on the season at 3-0. We've got some things to work on. Our offense definitely needs to improve as we had a pretty solid 4th quarter, but the first 3 quarters, only 3 points. That is not good at all. And our defense, we did a great job through the first 3 quarters, only allowing 9 points for Seattle. But things got a little weird in the 4th quarter as we let Russell Wilson run over us in overtime, and then a lot of really, really just unfortunate plays. And here goes Russell Wilson scoring that one touchdown that I was talking about. We cannot allow that to happen against other mobile quarterbacks. And there goes a touchdown by Marshawn Lynch. And that one would ultimately end this game. Denard Robinson with the play of the game where he ran all the way downfield. And we'll take one more look here at this final play. I don't understand what happened here. We have 32 seconds left. We had a 3-yard run, a negative 3-yard run by Doug Martin. There was 2 timeouts left. A 3-yard run does not take 32 seconds off the clock. Look at the time difference between the other plays. 4 seconds, 3 seconds. So what happened here? This is the final screenshot before that overtime started. 28 seconds. We have a timeout. Why didn't we kick a field goal? And if we had kicked the field goal we had missed, then the offense for Seattle would have had the ball back with like 20 seconds left. So obviously we didn't kick the field goal. There was something that happened with the simulation. There's no fumble, there's no turnover. It's just a 3-yard loss with 32 seconds left. So ultimately, we got robbed. The game is fixed. Mike Glennon goes 32 of 48 for 382 yards. He had no touchdowns in the game and 3 interceptions. That is inexcusable. Just completely disgusting. That's why Seattle had a little short drive starting at the 10-yard line. Doug Martin on the game, 19 carries for 70 yards, 3.6 yards per carry. He had the three touchdowns that we scored in this game. Only if he could have scored just one more touchdown. Stevie Johnson, 12 catches for 169 yards. He had a big 34-yard catch that got us inside the red zone with under a minute left in the fourth quarter. And ultimately, you guys saw it there. We got robbed by the Madden simulation. Checking out Russell Wilson's stats. 15 of 18 for 235 yards. I really need to do something about these sliders. 83-yard completion percentage, one touchdown, no interceptions. And he had about 13 yards per completion, and 7-8 yards was his longest throw. That one went to Denard Robinson. Looking at Marshawn Lynch on the ground, 30 carries for 119 yards, about 3.9 yards per carry, which isn't terrible. He had one touchdown. Kyrie Robinson, 6 for 15 for no touchdowns. And then Russell Wilson, he had 4 carries for 57 yards and a touchdown. One really big run coming in overtime. They got them down to the 15-yard line. And that was just really disappointing. Denard Robinson, 3 catches for 120 yards. One of those 78 yards. Ace Sanders, 4 for 47. He got knocked out of the game. Ted Ginn, 1 for 31. Kenny Stills, 1 for 9. Braylon Harris, 1 for 6. Marshawn Lynch, and then Jed Collins. And looking at the total stat breakdown, we did a pretty good job in the second half, especially the fourth quarter on offense. We definitely stepped things up. But those three interceptions by Mike Glennon, that really screwed us over. A lot of short fields for Seattle where they picked up a lot of field goals. As you guys see, they were hell scoreless in the first quarter. They picked up 3 field goals in the second quarter. And, I mean, after that, it was... I mean, it's really hard to play well on defense when your offense is giving the opponents the ball at the 10-yard line. That's a really, really big issue. And Mike Glenn needs to get that figured out. So we got to Russell Wilson 7 times in the game. We had 1 takeaway, but ultimately, like I said, it was the 3 takeaways by Seattle. And also the fact that we were robbed in overtime, which I am never going to live down. That is so annoying that the offense drove downfield, had 2 timeouts, called 1, ran the ball, and then didn't call another timeout to kick the field goal. And I was so annoyed by that loss, I actually didn't check the defensive stats at the end of the game. I wanted to see who got the 3 picks on Mike Glennon. But I actually ended up being named Defensive Player of the Week once again in the NFC. 16 tackles, 2 sacks, no interceptions, 1 forced fumble. Not a bad game at all. And that'll pretty much do it here for week number 3. Week number 4 is going to be a bye week. And because I'm doing these episodes week by week and not in bunches like in Road to Glory, we'll just skip week number 4 and move on to week number 5 where we have the New York Jets at home. But that'll pretty much do it for this episode. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one. I'm out of here.